just like a tank of gasoline or a bullet in a gun, a battery has a lot of energy in it. And if that energy is released in a way that we don't want it to be released, a fire can occur or even an explosion. Nowadays, lithium-ion batteries are used in pretty much everything from children's toys to laptop computers, our cell phones, power tools, and even some vehicles. If there was a simple way to describe why a battery would catch fire and explode, there'd be a simple way to prevent it from happening. There's a lot of pieces and processes that go into making the battery work. If any of those processes go wrong, there's a chance for energy to be released. And the reason that happens really is because the electrolyte inside of the battery is an organic solvent, and that solvent is flammable. So if the battery can't vent, you build up pressure as the electrolyte burns, and then it explodes. Thousands of these things are being made per hour, if not hundreds of thousands. And in that mass production process, if something goes wrong even a little bit, it might be very difficult to catch, but small mistakes lead to big problems down the line. In previous instances of batteries catching fire, the cause has been bad welds. A lot of the pieces of the battery are welded together, and if you don't have a good weld, you develop resistance. The resistance develops heat. Heat leads to fire. Other times it has been because of contaminants during the building process. Contaminants were generated, a little bit of metal scraped inside of a machine, and that contaminant fell into the cell, and that caused a hard short between the anode and cathode, which then generated heat, and so on and so forth. Generally, there's lots of different approaches that are being looked at on ways to make batteries safer. Really, the cutting edge approach, what's being looked at here on campus, is an all solid state electrolyte. So we would remove the flammable liquid entirely from the cell and just put down a ceramic layer that is capable of conducting lithium ions but not electrons to allow the anode and cathode to talk to each other in a way that is functional and not going to short out the cell. You know, there are lithium-ion batteries everywhere around us all of the time, and the vast, vast majority of cases, nothing goes wrong. A battery is stored energy. Whenever you have stored energy, there's the potential for that energy to be released in a way that we don't want it to be. Accidents do happen, but to combat that, there are professors here on campus, including Dr. Sakamoto and Dr. Dasgupta, who are looking at different ways to make batteries and make them safer for future use.